want you to imagine for a moment that you're dead. It's not the most inspiring way to start a talk, I know. You follow that white light through, and you come out into a warehouse, an empty hangar, and on the ground in front of you are thousands of Polaroid photographs, lined up one after the other in a row. Each photograph represents a day of your life, a life just ended. Walk past all these big days, the day you graduated university, the day you got married. You remember all these big days as you walk along these rows, and even there'll be some memories that you walk past each day that you remember. There'll be small things, like the day your eight-year-old son and his friend took your brand new Converse runners and filled them with mashed banana for a joke. You know? These days will stand out to you. And on you walk. My point is this. Each photograph on the floor in front of you is a unique day. The photograph is the thing that happened on that day that was different to every other day of your life, different from before and different from after. It was the new thing that you learned, the new experience that you had. And in the early years, as a child or a teenager, the pictures are quite interesting. Because when you're young, you're adventurous, you flirt with risk. But I want you to think about those rows that represent your late 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s. The days that become a routine, days slipping into weeks, into months, into years. You do the same thing every day. You get up, you go to school or college, you work, you come home, you sit on the TV. These days, think about the photographs and how many of those photographs are black. Blank, because you didn't do anything that day that was unique, that you had never, ever done before. Think of the rows and rows of photographs as you walk along that are completely blank. A life that could have been full of all sorts of new experiences, new skills, new people, new places, but it was just a routine life. And what you are holding here is your life. This is your entire life. How you're going to take more risk in your personal life, in your business life, and how that risk is going to enrich your life and then lead to being more creative and being more innovative in what you do. Is that you are responsible. Personally, you are responsible for your own creativity. Nobody else is. And how are we going to be creative in life if we do the same thing every day? If you do the same thing every day in your family, in your relationships, in your business life, how do you think you're going to suddenly be different? How do you think that suddenly you're going to have new ideas, suddenly be a different person? Because you know what? You're not. You have to do new things to encourage yourself to grow.
You watch your six-year-old daughter paint her toenails and you say, how did I get to be 40 and never had my toenails painted? And this one, she painted my toenails. And I no joke, this is one of the best things I did all year. For 2 weeks, I woke up every morning, swung my legs out of bed, and laughed. It was like having M&Ms for toes. And I put my socks on, and I... Thank you. It gets better. I put my socks on, and of course you'd forget. Of course you'd forget. And then you'd go about your business, you'd work all day, and at the end of the day, you take your socks off and you go, ha, M&Ms. And for 2 weeks, I smiled and I laughed twice a day. And I thought to myself, do you know what? This is it. This is what life is about. We need to be reminded on a continuous basis to live a better life, to live a life that could be more full. Everyone wants creativity. Everyone wants innovation. They want this to lead them to success. But really what we need to do is understand how can we foster that creativity? How can we foster an everyday sense of play? How can we make the people who work in our hospitals, in our schools, in our small businesses, in our corporations more playful every day so we can fuel this creativity? So if we're going to solve problems in new ways in the world, if we're going to challenge norms and push boundaries, then it needs to start with you. It needs to start with the individual. You can't hope that a corporation will do it for you. And it also has to last. This can't be just a book you read or a TED talk you watched or a one-day workshop you went to. If we're going to be creative, it has to be a permanent thing. It has to become a philosophy for who you are and permeate your every moment, your everyday life. You know, don't take what's given for you, for granted.
Children naturally take risks when they play. Because it's a natural extension. Play is a way of exploration, of exploring the world. How far can I go? And so they play physically. How far can I go? Kids love to play with fire. Because how far can I go? What happens if I do this? Sometimes bad things. But that's how you learn. So how are you going to grow as a person, grow as a business, unless you start trying new things?
So there's a whole host of values there that you as a coach have to sit down with and think, okay, well, does that affect then how I coach? Does that affect how I get inside the minds of these players?
and how I can actually help these players achieve their best, not necessarily just by doing traditional coaching methods, but by understanding these values, you can actually unlock a higher performance in the athlete by understanding what motivates them as a person.
So these things, play leads to risk. Taking risks leads to being more creative, and being more creative is obviously the way to be innovative, to think of new ideas and to implement them, to actually do them. And risk is interesting because by its very nature, risk in needs asks you to commit. You have to commit. And that's where innovation starts. Because when you want to be creative, creativity is great, it's an idea, but it'll only stay an idea unless you actually start to invest and commit and make it happen. Outside, nice, and make a nice tight fist, tight as you can, strong as you can, lots of blood here, tight. Look at the board, take a couple of breaths, commit, right? All the way through, in your own time, okay?